cigar, I know I had it coming. It's so good to see you all tonight. How many people here are actually from Nashville? Two! Woo! We love that. We want to show you what this city's all about. My name is Scott Reeves, and I've been here a long time. As of late, I decided to bring my cousins to town. They've been doing this their entire life since they were about 3 years old. And I wanted to introduce them to Nashville because Nashville needed to be introduced to the Reeves Brothers. So I hope you guys enjoy it tonight. How many country music fans we have out here? We got a few. Nashville's got a few country music fans left.
Yeah, you might say that.
Anyway, we're gonna have fun tonight, man. You're gonna hear stuff that you might be familiar with, stuff you have no idea and you've never heard before. And we get requests now.
Hey, buddy, it's only a suggestion until you put money in this bucket.
We got a big old tip bucket up here. If you feel the urge,
if you feel it halfway up, we'll play wagon wheel. Promise.
Anyway, we gotta play it first. Come on, make the investment. What we're doing tonight is really, really a songwriter's round. We do this. Have you heard of the Bluebird Cafe? If you've ever watched the show Nashville, you might have seen it right here. Anyway, what we're doing up here is you'll hear songs that are originally hear songs that you might know that we wrote that have been on the radio. And we're gonna play some stuff just like Johnny that have influenced us over the years and kind of shaped who we are as artists. So anyway, welcome. Thank you, Puckett, for hosting us. And I'm gonna hand it off to my cousin Cole Reeves. Give him a big round of applause.
Thank you, guys.
I'm gonna
do something I wrote a couple years back, called Project Hitman, this will go cool with us being in Nashville tonight. I wrote this thing on a ride home from Las Vegas. We lived out in Nevada for a long time and played music out there in Vegas. And on the way home one night, we went to a gig and nobody clapped. Nobody's hardly there. And man, nobody was.
Don't do that to us.
Don't do that to us.
Just make
clap.
Us feel good.
You can even try it right now if you want to. Just get ready. You guys, I love you already.
Cold, man. I mean, when we play a song that you've never heard that we've written, this is what happens in Nashville. We all get together and co-write songs, and some of the best songs you've never heard will never be heard. So this is stuff that we do every day in Nashville for the past, I don't know, 50 years, it's been a lot, more than that. But anyway, Cole, sing him a song you just wrote.
It is. All right, this is called Problem Fit Man. I hope you guys like it.
I don't own a pickup truck.
truck, and I don't ride around on old dirt roads. I gave up on country music, and they gave up on Haggard and George Jones. Wait a minute, they gave up on Haggard and George Jones. I can't stand the taste of whiskey. We gotta watch the tear apart my happy home. Saturday night was on my breath. She drove off on Sunday all alone.
But Matt and Cole, you probably didn't realize it, but I'm a couple years older than them.
You probably didn't notice. He looks great. He's got just skin.
65.
And there they are.
I'll take it, man. I'll take it. I used to hold these boys, these big boys, who are much bigger than me now, when they were babies. And watching them on stage with my Uncle Jack Reeves, it was so much fun watching them grow up into who they are now as musicians and artists. They've been doing this since they were two. You guys have no idea how honored I am to have you guys out here with me and up here and getting to show you off. So, ladies and gentlemen, Matthew Reeves.
Thank you very much. We're on this song right now that me and your Uncle Jeff, my dad, wrote. So I actually played this at the Ryman's a long time ago.
Was that at the Colgate Country Show?
Yeah.
He was like in the top five for the Colgate Country Showdown.
A long time ago.
About to play
before line. I could grow a mustache. And so I knew
that. You were shaving it for later, my dad.
I was shaving it for later, yeah. Anyway, so we're going to do this thing right now. We play a lot down in Texas, and this is kind of a Texas hillbilly song. Goes something like this. Well, I'm a long-haired, hot-blooded redneck, honky-tonk cowboy.
Slide. I can do the two-step or I can do the ten-step with my cowgirl by my side. We may not know it, but I grew up a cowboy. And I grew up loving the cowboy way. I live in Dallas, I live in Fort Worth, and I'm in the San Antonio. And the big state of Texas, honky-tonk, it is the best. Never I can do the 10-step with my cowgirl by my side.
Now we're going to introduce to you our wonderful and always talented cousin, Scott Reeves. Put your hands together.
All right, well, about 18 years back, I still am part of a group called Blue County. And this was our first song on country radio. I don't know how long that may be older than a lot of you kids out there. Yeah. Were you born in 2003? Okay. I didn't know. I mean, 2002? 97. Okay. Oh man, you can still you be my kid. That's true. Well, we were on the road as Blue County back in 2003. And this was our first single. And I'm going to need your help in the middle of it. Well, I got solo guitar players here, so I couldn't have it do a solo if I wanted to. But I think it'd be more fun to have you guys join us a little bit. And you'll know what I mean. We're gonna substitute a bridge. It's not that you have a bridge. But we're gonna make a bridge. Make our own bridge. This was on country radio, came out in 2003, put us on the map. We were out touring with everyone and their mother the following month, which is kind of cool. But anyway, this is what got it off. How many bachelorettes do we have here tonight? Bachelors. Bachelorettes and a girl for this young lady. It's okay. Someone identifying as a bachelorette here, so this is for you, buddy.
Striking young woman.
Come on!
and one more guitar. I got a 7-inch scar on the backside of my arm from fighting in a bar. It's a whole nother discussion. Nothing's ever cut me this deep. Never been wounded like the way you did. You left that hole in my chest where my heart used to be. Left me wasted, obliterated. Now that I've tasted the love you laid on me, girl. Nobody gonna shit, guess I'll have to grin and bear. Gonna have to dig my way out of here. This one's gonna need a mark, deep and wide and dark. And if I make it out alive, I'll have a tale to tell. Never been wounded like the way you did. You left that hole in my chest where my heart used to be. Left me wasted, give a dang so I can move on. I can move on, yeah. Never been wounded quite the way you did. You left that hole.
Because our cousin, his wife, and Matt and I's cousin, Missy, always says, these people are not here to be depressed and brought down.
No, it's true.
And I'm a downer. I like to write ballads.
You like to watch movies and make me cry.
I like to watch The Notebook. I'll cry to The Notebook. Sue me. Not a problem. I'm a sensitive person. Getting a little emotional. Emily gets emotional.
She does.
We've got that in common. Emily, you cried at the movie you went to see last night, didn't you? She's pregnant. She's got that door for her. That's probably part of it. But I'm not pregnant.
Not all of it.
Is that all of it? I'm not pregnant. I just look pregnant. Anyway, I'm going to slow down a little bit, and I'm apologizing to you up front, and please forgive me, because that's probably the most you can get out of me. It's a slow song tonight, and getting up, Johnny. We got Johnny Isaac back here. He's come to see us, and we love you, Johnny. Put a hand for a round of applause for Johnny Isaac one night. Woo! Johnny Isaac, please. You were on Universal, right? Universal Records right there for a long time.
Y'all have a good night. Thank you for being here.
Yeah, thank y'all for coming out. Anyway, I called up Greg. I wrote this song after a trip to Arizona.
So look at they all, see, you're all in on the inside scene now. You can call me Greg and no one will blink.
Yeah, okay, Scott. I'm going to call you Scott. After getting in Arizona, after my sobriety was compromised, I went out to the parking lot and gave my shirt I was wearing to a girl, and I got a red bandana, and this is where the song came from. Anyway, I called up my cousin here, and he went into the music bank in Franklin and lay down some harmony for me, so if you will.
Well, I'll give her my best shot, though. I don't want to mess him up.
Can I see that tune for 1 second?
I would love to give you
this. This is my favorite song. You're going to hear this song over and over again tonight. It's called Tuning.
these guys again, you guys are gonna hear more about these guys and more from these guys. And follow them at the Reeves Brothers on Instagram. I'm a Scott Reeves official. I always pop stuff up. They're doing a lot of stuff here now, and they're starting to get some traction. And you guys are going to be able to come see them quite a bit more often. And hopefully you're going to hear them.
I can't believe the Reeves Brothers got me in trouble.
What amazes me about these boys is, like I said, they've been doing this since they were 2 or 3 years old, literally. My Uncle Jack worked with Vern Gosden at one point. And for all of you old school country musicers out there. And they are diehard 70s country music fans. And they have not compromised that. That's what I love about them.
Thank you for the story, Pat, Emily. I appreciate that. By the way, we got an answer for him. Yes, the Reeves Brothers. And you guys feel free to tag us in some stories and stuff, because we love that.
And I got to get these boys back to Arkansas in a couple of days, so if you fill up that white bucket right there for gas.
The bachelorette party did at least.
Yeah, the bachelorette party down here.
Spin it all on Broadway over there.
Anyway, this thing called Fitting She's the Reason I Keep Coming Back. Lights are shining bright tonight on Highway 10. I come this way to Texas every now and then. The sky's lit up to make a perfect view. The stars remind me how much I've been missing you. Got some Alpinans in here.
Are those some real bastards over there in the corner? Okay, well,
Congratulations.
Authentic bachelorettes over there.
Yeah.
I thought I saw you just ride by on one of those open top bus things with a bunch of covered lights dancing.
Oh, yes. That party will end as soon as you put that ring on, so enjoy it.
Cole was a bachelorette once.
I was.
We're all doing this for you. Here's a little boogie woogie. Wow!
Just visiting for the weekend. Okay, well, you're going to have to come back. And come 50 miles in the rain? 350 miles in the rain on bikes? Oh, come on!
God bless you.
Be careful, man. But we're going to be at the listening room on October 27th for a real special show. Leslie Satcher and I and these boys are going to be doing a show around there like this, and then the second late show is going to be the Reeves Brothers with their band Full On. So that'll be a treat. Anyway, I'm going to do a song. I'm going to get this out of the way. This is a song I wrote. Oh, goodness, a few years back, and it's interesting. We live in such a weird time right now, don't we? In the world.
Sort of we do.
Seriously, it's a strange time. It's unlike it was 2 years ago. It's just a different time. And so, it's still America. That's right. America, we are blessed to live in America, I'm telling you. You can't argue that, right? So, it's interesting, because the last couple times I've sang this out at a writer's round, I thought, man, I wrote it, and it's really for, I wrote it for my grandfather, and because it honors him, who taught me everything I know, taught me to work hard, you know, keep my hands dirty, and he had dirty hands and a clean soul, man, and he loved his country, appreciated where we live, and the freedoms we have, and the beauty of it is we have, freedom means everybody can have their own opinion, and it's okay. You can live your life the way you want to live it. Hey, you're in America, buddy. And you ain't going to be able to do that in a lot of other places, so we are fortunate, man. So, anyway, this was a song that I wrote for my grandma and grandpa, who have since passed, and they were amazing. So, I hope you hear this the right way. Thank you, Toby Keith. I don't care who cuts my songs as long as they take them up to the top. My old man, who's that old man, spent his life living off the land. His heart singing foreign calls, filled with the few that is ours. Wearing cotton we didn't grow. He's got the red, white, blue, flying high on the farm. Simplified tattooed on his left arm. Still a little more in the store for a tank. The back says USA. Hey, won't buy nothing that he can't fix. He'll WD-40. Decorates on the 4th of July, but since every day is Independence Day. Just go in the room, did you teach a school? Some folks say it ain't cool, but she says a pledge of allegiance anyway. Anyway, like I said, thank you guys for being here. We're blessed to be here. And we're blessed to be able to be who we are in America. Because we have choices. So, it's a good thing. Mr. Cole Reeves. Again, these guys, the Reeves Brothers, at the Reeves Brothers on Instagram. Cousin Scott is going to show them off to Nashville as much as I can.
I love you, Scott.
Have a good night, y'all.
I'm going to do my cousin Nate over here.
Oh, hey, cousin Nate.
Oh, man.
My cousin Nate is here. And he likes a song. And when somebody tells me they like a song I write, I latch on to them because not many people like it. So he wrote this saying, I wrote this saying, and he likes it. So I'm hearing it from my cousin Nate. I wrote this a while back, and it's a thing called Drinker Out My Mind.
You didn't answer my last call. Saying this could be goodbye. But the wells have all ran dry. I've been drank to put the fire around. Up your burning love affair. You're someone new who's replacing me. Just let my heart be despair. It's time to open up the honky tonk. I'll two-step a memory of my mind. If they're not those swinging doors, I always hate when it comes to an end. They throw me out at closing time. They need to make it 7:24 so I can drink her off my mind. Catch the bugs and neon signs, casting shadows on the floor. We probably just be getting home. If things were like they were before, I need a place where I can get set up. There's broken hearts on every street. Can't be the only one who's all alone. I gotta make it short and sweet. It's time to open up the honky tonks. Throw some sawdust on the floor. I'll two-step a memory on my mind. If they're like those swinging doors, I always hate when it comes to an end. And they throw me out at closing time. They need to make it 7:24 so I can drink her off my mind. When you're drinking all night long, you can take some hard hit down with a jukebox full of memories playing old familiar sounds. Open up the honky tonks, throw some sawdust on the floor. I two-step a memory on my mind. If they're like those swinging doors, I always hate when it comes to an end. They throw me out at closing time. They need to make it 7:24 so I can drink her off my mind. They need to make it 7:24 so I can drink her off my mind.
Stage from the time they were 2 years old with their dad, and it's just amazing. It's so fun to see them now. I am so proud. I'm honored to be I really fully believe the next stepping stone for everyone to hear these boys. because they're too good not to be heard. What you got going for us, Matt Reeves?
Well, I'm going to do a song I wrote about this old guitar.
Yes, and I love it.
Like Scott has said, there's always been a guitar in my hand since I can remember. And I have a certain old Mark guitar at home, and this kind of inspired this song I was looking at one day. This is called This Old Guitar. Well, this old guitar smelled a lot of smoke and seen it share barroom. Cheap motels and made its way to Nashville, Tennessee. From around an auditorium to the palm trees out in Southern California. He's my best friend, will I strum away from the next cold bed.
Hey, thank you.
buddy.
Man, I knew I should have spent more time playing guitar when I was a kid. I'm telling you, man. They're just wonderful. Hey, can I bring someone up here to do a song for y'all? How would you like to hear a 38-week pregnant year old, 38-year-old pregnant year old,
38-week,
who would be my daughter?
No,
can I get another one, please?
Yeah.
Hey, Emily, come on up here. I want you to play a song.
Yeah.
She's been playing with me since she was just a baby. And,
she gives birth next
month. She's why I kept on doing what I was doing. And these boys are why I kept on, just to get these guys out of here to show you guys. And she's about to give us the third grandchild. Not third for her, but it's her second.
She's so pregnant.
Did not know this.
Nathan Smith. Yeah, you are real crazy. He's about to, yeah. Just don't let anything happen while you're up on stage.
It might be our fault.
You get up here and deliver it for me.
Yeah, she gives birth in like 3 weeks.
Emily Reeves. She's the reason I do what I do.
Scott told us earlier this morning that this is her last outing.
I've been married 3 years, man. Sorry. I've been married to that guy 3 years and I've been called Emily Reeves. I'm gonna get it. Oh man, that's terrible. I owe you something, buddy.
I think it's our fault she's on stage because earlier we were saying how much we wanted her to sing tonight, too. She's like, oh, maybe we can get her up there to sing a song.
I don't even know what to play, that's what I meant. I don't even know what to start with.
You gonna request? Yell it out.
Yeah, Goodbye,
Colorado.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, well, my name's Emily Smith, as y'all know. It's good to be up here. I'm so excited. It's been forever since I played Puckett, Nashville, so thanks for having me up. Happy you guys have been killing me. Oh my gosh, the Reeves Brothers. I don't just say this because they're my cousins, y'all. They are truly one of my favorite artists. I love them. I'm so glad y'all are getting to hear them tonight. They're great. And this is a song called Goodbye, Colorado.
Thank you.
Guitars the last time too. The last time they sing this happened.
All character. This is a song I played with my husband. I wrote it with my dad actually, and a writer in town named Casey Timmer, who's great as well. And this is what we like to call our bluegrass wedding song. I was almost singing out with a real deep voice, but not even pretty.
I wanna build a house on the hill with you.
That was a fun trip.
Next time you hear it, it'll be two of you.
Yeah!
Tour, yeah, you're right, it is.
Thank you, Cole, for giving me your spot.
Guitar doesn't turn down. Maddie, you want to see one?
Yeah, I want to do a barn burner here.
Burn the barn down, brother. Burn.
Now, this is the lady I watched. I wanted to start watching Days with. That's Maddie. She's Julie's mother, and she's also supposedly Cole's mother. Here she is in 1962.
Twilight
Zone. Oh, wow. That's so cool. When they I'm gonna make it. there was a boy out in Arkansas that would wear his head to his mama. She'd go in the beach and go to school. He'd sneak away every afternoon from the little spot named Pretty Soon. He'd find him at the local auction bar. He'd stand and listen carefully, and then pretty soon he began to see how the auctioneer could talk so rapidly. He said, "Oh my, it's new back, and I've got to learn that auction crack. I'll make the mark to be an auctioneer. $45 bid. Hey, so from this camp, went to school, there grew a man and put it cool. He came back home full-fledged auctioneer. People came for miles around to hear him make his rhythmic sound, and it filled their hearts with such a happy cheer. His face spread out from shore to shore. The boy had all he could do, and more he had to buy plenty to get around. Now he's a toxin old man. Let's pause and give that man. He's the best hillbilly auctioneer.
I could because I care.
You'd be good to do with them, brother. You are a lover, not a fighter.
I am.
They were right here all along.
But you couldn't. He doesn't advise when he's in person. 6 years ago.
See, you have to enjoy the soothing sounds of me.
Can I borrow a tune around here about tune?
James is back.
Can I have my tuner back? I need another tuner.
Hey kid, give me your tuner. Give me my tuner back. That's a guitar that sounds like tuner.
You boys are gonna sleep good.
But they're dressed up.
You're almost gonna be able to get home back to Arkansas.
Every dollar you give us buys us another Dr. Pepper.
That's right. Well.
Hey, cut off.
It's not gonna be my last song, but in the video we'll do our song we just wrote with Steve Dean, a tribute to your dad. We'll talk about that in a second. This one, we can't go there just yet. We gotta.
I hope so, and I didn't.
Where are you guys from?
The first three quarters of what you said.
Virginia, you from the beach area?
Yeah.
Okay, you look like beach dudes, man. You look like. I know you do. You look like you got some sun. A sailing shirt, I like it. Well, this is for you, buddy. We're about to fall in fall, and winter's upon us almost. Y'all ever heard of King Jesse?
Yep.
Yeah. Heard of him?
I'm gonna end.
I wrote this
now.
For Kenny.
I'll post this video though.
He doesn't know it yet.
Sing your song. We're running out of time, 'cause you'll be gone. I'm betting online. Sing your song and carry on with what you left behind. Daddy left to play again. He's already. Leads away to one more song. breakfast off the table, but he don't need a light. He's somewhere in the greens before he takes the stage right. Sing your song, give me one more line, pass it on. We're running out of time. You'll be gone. I'm betting on a ride. Sing your song and carry on with what you left behind. The rocking chairs while you're still there, I'll be here right beside you. To sing your song, give me one more line to pass it on. We're running out of time, cause when you're gone, and I'm betting on a ride, sing your song and carry on with what you left behind. I'll sing your song and carry on with what you left behind.
Guys, we love you, thank you, and we will see y'all next time.